Hello, stitchy friends of Flosstube. I'm back for my third video. It's quickly becoming the best part of my stitchy week. I'm super excited to be doing another one. Super excited that my husband actually finished editing my first video so I could put that back up with my introduction and some finished pieces that I did on that one. Monday is a great day now that I have Flosstube recordings to look forward to after work. So, thanks for joining me again. Hope everyone had a great week and a great Easter weekend. We had a great weekend with my family, or a great Easter with my family, dinner. The kids got to do an Easter egg hunt. They were so stinking cute. And we've got an almost 2-year-old and almost 4-year-old, and, my son and I actually joined my parents for church yesterday morning. I was raised Catholic. I usually go to a non-denominational church, and my son has come with me a couple times. But he went with me to my parents' church, and he was so cute. We went up for communion, and the Eucharistic minister put his hand out to give my son a blessing. My son reached his little hand up and gave him a high five. Everybody was laughing about that, and he didn't think anything of it, but it was so stinking cute. So that was fun. But anyway, other than that, I haven't had a whole lot this week. I didn't get a whole lot of stitching time on my whips, but I did have a lot of FFOs. A lot of you saw them in Stitch Mania. I'm sure I got annoying posting one after another. But I'm a procrastinator, and when I finish stitching, it gets tucked away, and I don't do anything with it right away because I guess I'm kind of lazy. And that's okay. I'll be honest about that. I just let them stack up, and then, like, this week I had a productive week and finished 6. So that was pretty cool. Let's see. Other new things for me. This is somewhat stitching related, but I just I got some new jewelry. I have to show you. I got this little scissor charm, and this is my new favorite bracelet. Because they didn't have anything sewing necessarily, but I got the scissors, and I just love it. So that's my new thing. I actually became addicted to these. It's a company called Keep Collective, and I ordered from a couple different parties, and then I was like, ah, screw it. I want the kit. So I signed up, and so I'm doing a couple Facebook parties here and there, but I just love my little scissors, and I'm going to order the letters so that I can spell stitch and use the scissors for one of the T's. Yeah, so I'm excited about that. But let's get into... I'm going to start with my promised segment, my little ornament collection. I went down in the basement looking for all my Christmas ornaments, and I'm still missing, I know of at least 3, because I did 3 sled ornaments, and they were, it was an angel, Mary and Babe, and Joseph. And so, and those were Foxwood Crossings. It was Foxwood Crossings pattern. I know I have them. I just don't know where. But I'll start with, this was from an ornament exchange that we did at the LNS this year, or this past Christmas. And it was kind of a quick thing. I asked the owner if I could, throw together, if we could do something, hoping it would draw in some people, because she had just moved her stitching out to the cross stitch shop, or I'm sorry, out to the quilt shop. So I kind of thought it would be, get a couple new people in maybe. And we did end up selling a ton of the patterns and sleds for these. And I think we had 10 or 12 people actually sign up for the exchange. So we decided we would do a theme, and the theme was the sled ornaments. We let everybody pick whatever they wanted to do pattern wise. And then decided that this year we'll pick a theme in the summer, give people more time to get creative and do whatever they want for their ornament. So looking forward to that too. These ornaments I actually picked up at a craft show, and they are done on metallic perforated paper. And I picked them up because I really just wanted them to make them for myself too. And I just love how she attached, little trim and bells and everything on them. So I did end up making a few of these for coworkers this year and or this past year, and they were happy with those. But love those. So they'll go on my stitchy tree eventually, but those were not stitched by me. This was an ornament that I finished last year. Heart and Hand, I believe. Sorry, don't remember the pattern name. I'm horrible with that. I don't have it written down anywhere either, and I actually did sell somebody the pattern. So, but that one is one of those that they have it segmented into the quarters, and then you just keep rotating. So that was last year. This one I stitched a long, 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 long time ago, and I just pulled it out last year, stuck a cord and some felt on the back so that I could get it on the tree at the shop when we decorated for Christmas. And this one was my daughter's first Christmas ornament. And I got the pattern from a cross stitch, just cross stitch ornament issue. And all I did was wrap it on mat board, and same with the back. Got the fabric from the quilt shop. We sell some fat eighths, so I've been known to go through that and stack up on fabrics that I think I might use on ornaments. And then just got this little pom-pom trim and finished that off. So there's my daughter's first Christmas ornament. That was all of the ornaments that I could find. Like I said, I know I have more. They'll probably sneak their ways in at some point, especially come Christmas when I can show off my tree with more ornaments. Like the one I just showed you for my daughter, my plan is to stitch an ornament for my kids every year. I'm a little bit behind, but I have each year picked out so far, so that's an accomplishment. I just also need to get notebooks so I can kind of keep track because I am picking themes, or not necessarily a theme, but something that works. Like their first year, I just picked what I like. Excuse me a second. My dog is scratching at the door and apparently needs to go out now. Oxy noodles. There you go. Go on. Go potties. Sorry about that. Anyway, my kid's first year ornament is just one that I pick, something I like. You'll see my son's. It's an owl, and I love owls. So my friends got to calling the baby Hoot when I was pregnant, so I went with an owl for him. Ellery, I just picked something cute that I liked. Added the first Christmas in the year, and then their each other ornament is going to have something to do with. Not necessarily milestones, but something cute or fun or rememberable that they did that year. The last year, the big thing we did was put the kids in swim lessons. And so I got a fish ornament for my son. It's a Mill Hill beaded kit, and it's an orange fish. It is tropical, but it's orange. And I figured we'd do that because the swim lessons were done through Goldfish Swim School. So kind of ties in with what we did with him for the year, something big that stuck out. So I'd like to write those all down so that one day when the kids have all their ornaments, they've got the memories that go with them as well, or the stories behind them. So I'll eventually get to getting that done. I'll have to go find some cute little notebooks that I can keep with their ornaments. Let's see. Well, like I mentioned before, whips, I did not get a ton of stitching time this week. My main whip that I focused on at work, I have the one that I had at work and it turned into a finish. And it is my Bent Creek Pumpkin of Leaves. If anybody else has this pattern, or has seen it at least, you'll notice I did change the stem. The stem was charted to be just a solid rectangle. I really didn't like the way it looked, so I kind of just freehanded and added some stitches to turn it and make it more look like a stem. Love the little owl that's on top. It's so cute. Quick stitch. This one went very quickly, and like I said, I only work on this at work, my lunch break or other breaks if we don't walk. So I have another new pattern at work that I'll be working on. The other whip that I worked on at home also turned into a finish and an FFO. It was a pattern by Ursula Michael. It's in the cross stitch Ultimate Cross Stitch Flower magazine, and it was her Violets pattern, and I did turn that into a Biscornu. Let's see, on the sides, on the corners, on the back, I just did the same motif as the front. Did not stitch anything on the back, and I opted to not squish it in the center with a button just because I didn't really want to put it in the center of those flowers. But this is stitched on hand-dyed fabrics by Stephanie, 28 count Joblin, and it's in honey amber. I feel like this camera is so set on focusing on me, it's not going to focus on anything I show you. I'm going to have to play around with that, so I apologize. Put it right here. There. So that's done. Everything else that I've got for today is the FFOs that I did. This was a Shepherd's Bush kit, and I stitched this last year. This was my first Shepherd's Bush. I really, really liked how it stitched up, how it turned out. And then for finishing, I actually got this kit. Was finishing forms, quick and easy ornament finishing, and it was two little metal discs basically, and you stretched your piece out over it, and it suggested putting I think it was just muslin in between, which is what I did just to get it to grab a little bit better. Did the same thing for the back, a layer of muslin and then the fabric that I chose. And then all I did was stitch this cording around the edge. It's not the best finish in my opinion. I'm not happy with how it lined up. I feel like those pieces should have snapped together or something. If anybody else has used these finishing forms, maybe you can enlighten me. I don't know. Maybe I did something wrong. I don't know. But they didn't fit together snugly like I wanted. I feel like they did not line up right. I basically put the cording on there to hide the overlap. So not sure that I would use them again, but it did work. It's all right. Not happy with how off-center it is either. I didn't really get that good enough, but that's okay. It was a learning experience. My next FFO, this was a small chart that I stitched up for my friend. She's actually our daycare provider as well. She just redid her whole kitchen and has a little coffee and tea nook. So I stitched this up as a little birthday gift for her. Her birthday was the end of March, so I'm a little bit late getting it to her. But she knows that I was still finishing it off, so I'll send that to daycare with the kids in the morning. Hopefully she has a good spot for that. Then I have my first box finish. This was a class that I took at my LNS. I'm not patient enough for these. I want things done quick. It tested my patience. I like it. Very happy with how it turned out. I think it looks good on the seams. I'm happy with that. But I just want it done immediately. I need to learn how to be more patient, I guess. So we've got little blue beads on here for the feet. I went super simple with my bow. I might untie that. I didn't tack it down or anything, so I may untie that later and check out some YouTube tutorials on ribbon tying. I'm not sure. I was happy with that. Probably going to take this to my office, put it in there for decoration. It's where I sit most of the day, every day. So, might as well enjoy it there. Next I have, it's an FFO, but it's not an FFO. This is my son's first Christmas ornament. I got lazy and put the cording on with a hot glue gun. I regret that. I was about at my max for dealing with hand sewing. I have a glob here that I just am not happy with. So now I need to find something to cover it up. Buttons, bells, I don't know yet. I'll figure it out later. Maybe tie a ribbon, I don't know. But other than that, it's an FFO. And I'm calling it good. So. This next one is another one of my son's Christmas ornaments. This one was another Just Cross Stitch magazine. I'm sorry, his first year ornament was as well. It was a pattern I got from a Just Cross Stitch ornament issue. This one I modified. His favorite book that year for 2015 was The Little Blue Truck. So of course I had to turn the red truck into a blue truck. And in the book, there's no driver for the truck. So I took him out from the pattern. Left the rooster though, because there's animals in the Little Blue Truck book. Left the Christmas tree as well. Very happy with how that turned out. Very happy with the stitching I did for the date, because I just kind of went with it freehand. I didn't feel like charting it. This one I stitched together in a pillow. Actually, my mom stitched it together in a pillow for me because I didn't feel like pulling my sewing machine out. I had two small projects that I was going to do in pillow form. I took them with me to Easter. After we ate, we went down to the basement and mom quickly threw them through her sewing machine and I turned them right side out and I came home. And I put this ribbon edging on. This was awesome for hiding seams. I feel like I will use this edging a lot. I blame the Night Owl Stitcher because she was showing it off in some of her videos that I was catching up on last week. Thank you, thank you, thank you, because I love it. If you want to see more about it, there's a short 58-second YouTube video. It is, if you just search Shepherd's Bush Wonky Ribbon, and you can pull that up and watch that. I'm not going to lie. I had to watch it three or four times because it's not the best video. It's not like up close. I kind of had to play around with it after watching the video to figure it out. But, very happy with how that turned out. And when I got to the top, I just happened to stitched this, what's this called? You know, stuff. Anyway, a hanger, whatever. I forgot to put it in the seam when my mom stitched it up for me. So I just tied knots on the end. Let's see if it'll focus. No. Tied knots on the end, ran a couple passes through with the needle and stitched it to there. I thought it actually added some more to that little manly rustic touch kind of thing. So that one's, look at that, two ornaments for one kid are done. So last one that I have was a Lizzie Kate kit. It came with the pattern and the fabric. And then I actually bought it off of Stash Unload, and it had all of the threads in it as well, and the buttons. So I got that stitched up. That was a super quick stitch. Found coordinating fabric, ribbon, and beads, and just did that wonky ribbon edging on that one as well. I don't have a dough bowl yet. I have a bowl. It's not even a bowl. It's more of a tray. I don't like it because it's not deep enough for things to really sit up in. They all kind of fall flat. So I need to figure something out, get some kind of dish or something to display them, my little smalls in. And I'm starting to do a lot more smalls. I'd like to get some for each season holiday done, so. But there's a first Easter one for me. Let's see. Oh, I know what I was going to ask regarding FFOs. So all of these ornaments that I, or a couple of these ornaments that I did for my kids, I used mat board. I used to be able to go to Michael's right by my house and have them cut me scraps. I can technically actually cut myself scraps at work too. And I can just buy the scraps and use our mat cutter to cut them at work. But if I want to work on it like this last weekend, I was not prepared. I wanted to get them done. And I don't work again until Thursday. I went to Hobby Lobby for a couple other things, asked in their framing department. They had absolutely no scraps. They said to cut it themselves and pay for the whole piece. It was $1 per cut, yada yada. It was going to cost me like $24 to cut three pieces of mat board. And I said no. And that's why two of these ended up finished as pillows, because I refused to pay $24 for having the mat board cut. Went to Michael's, same thing. I mean, I've been there before for it. She said she didn't have any scraps. They used to have one location I went to, they actually had like 5x7 pieces that they would sell, and she would cut those down for me. She said she absolutely had none, yada yada. Same thing. It was going to be at least $10 to get what I wanted. She did eventually go back and find a small scrap for me and cut it. And I mean, I was happy to pay for it too. It was only a few bucks the last time I had done it when I had gotten six pieces before. And I asked her how much it would be, and she actually ended up just giving it to me for free. She said, "Don't worry about it." And I said, "Okay, well, happy to pay for it." She said, "Nope." But that being said, I'm kind of stuck with, I guess I have to plan better, maybe use the mat cutter at my L&S when I'm there, my shifts. But what do you guys use? I know I have seen some people use foam core. And actually, there was a picture in, I believe it was Stitch Mania a while ago, and it was Lizzie Kate Halloween. I think it was those Eeks patterns. And somebody had finished them on foam core and turned them into magnets, fridge magnets. And those were really cute. They wrapped ribbon around the edge. It was really liked those. But for framing, do you get a sheet? Do you cut it yourself? Is an X-Acto blade sharp enough to take care of that? How do you do it? Let me know. Comment. Tell me what I'm doing wrong. Tell me where I need to get it. I don't know. Haul, I guess, is next. First, if you remember from last video, I had gotten some haul and I had ordered, I believe this one came from eBay. It was a Mill Hill kit, and when I opened the plastic bag it was in, it just kind of reeked of smoke. Wasn't happy with it at all. I found these in the laundry section of Walmart. Skunkies, and it was a bag with two of these little pouches. It looks like just sock material. I don't know what's necessarily in it. I guess I could look. Eliminates odor and absorbs moisture, which helps prevent bacteria. Non-toxic. Blah blah, whatever. I thought it might help with the smoke because it says to use it for closets, drawers, trunks, cars, lockers, cubbies, sneakers, athletic gear, and any other place that needs a fresh scent. Kind of was hoping it would take care of the smoke smell. So I put it in a big bag with one of those. Let's see. It's better. I can still detect the underlying cigarette smell, I guess. But it's better. So maybe that's gonna work. I don't know. I wonder if I could throw it in my cedar closet. We have a cedar closet in the basement. Maybe that would help. I don't know. We'll see. But that might be an option for others as well, so I wanted to share that. I'm thinking it would be good also for sometimes people buy floss that, like, I bought some floss from somebody, and there was a faint, musty smell. Not like it was, you know, old and bad or anything. I don't know, just a slight odor. So I wonder if that would have helped with that. And I apologize, now my nose itches from that. Okay, next. I mentioned that I went to Hobby Lobby this week, and I got some goodies there. Some pins. I've been getting bad with counting. I thought these would make good counting pins. They have little spools of thread on them. Nothing too fancy. Picked up these buttons. They were on clearance. I'm really getting into the Biscornus, so just picked those up to have on hand. Picked up some more ribbon for wonky ribbon borders, or trim, sorry. These were all on clearance. So I got some shamrocks. I do have a couple of little St. Patrick's Day patterns that I thought that I could use that on. There's some pink roses. This was an animal print. This is a good baby print. So I've got a couple friends having kids, so that might end up in projects soon. I picked up this on, this must, I don't know if this was on clearance or not. I just started throwing stuff in the basket. Some more cord, orange, be good for Halloween. Start pulling out some Halloween, just cross stitch magazine soon. See about making some Halloween ornaments. Then I picked up, we talked a little bit about the Sulky Petites, the 12 weight thread. I found these and they were in the stitching aisle. They were on clearance, so I picked them up. It looks very similar in size to the Sulky. I don't know. But for the price, I'm going to try it. I liked the colors. Premium thread for all needle arts. I can't really see the brand. Lizbeth? Yep, Lizbeth. Size 20 thread. So, we'll see how that goes. And the last thing from Hobby Lobby, a little bit naughty. I've been eyeing this kit for a long time. I've mentioned my owl obsession. I have an owl tattooed on my foot. Needlework was 30% off. The kits, anyway. Oh, and they're clearancing out needlework kits again. My Hobby Lobby, at least, they haven't had a lot of these new ones for very long, and I'm already seeing clearance stickers. So I don't know what's going on with that. Maybe somebody else knows. But this one... Okay, how could I not get that for 30% off? Yeah, I know. The coupon's usually 40. I didn't do that math until after I got in the car. I just got excited because it said 30% off. So I'm really excited to start this one. This might be my next start, actually. I don't know. 27 count fabric? Really? Okay. We'll figure it out. So that was my last Hobby Lobby purchase. The rest of my haul, stash and load. Some of it was stuff that, like I mentioned, I purchased before I went on my stash diet again. So others were not. Whoops. But I'm still in the black because I sold a bunch. So, yay! I purchased this magazine. I really like that cardinal. My grandma likes birds. Maybe I'll stitch that for her. I did only find a couple patterns in here that I could see myself doing. This might be a quick stitch. Thought that was pretty. Make a little banner. And the bird, but also this winter scene. thought that was really pretty. We'll see. And then my other, let's see. This one actually just came in the mail today. My son that loves vehicles. He's going to be so excited if I can stitch him a police car, a fire truck, and an ambulance. I don't know what I'm going to stitch it on, but something. Or if nothing else, when he's a little bit older and wants to learn how to stitch, he can stitch those. Because he has expressed interest in it before. My other, let's see. Got this on stash and load. My coworker and good friend loves lighthouses. So I think I'm going to stitch that for her. I don't think I'm going to stitch this little part. But I'm going to stitch the lighthouse and the anchor. The main part there. I don't know. I should be able to finish it by Christmas, right? Last of stash unload. I got somebody was selling stitchy box. And I got super excited and had to get them. I'm not gonna take everything out. But here's my two bags of goodies. So I have a Halloween and a Christmas stitchy box. I'm excited to do some small projects with those. Especially since I signed up for the 2017 Christmas stitchy box. So this is kind of a good preview for me. Excited about that. Then I have three new scissor fobs. Charisse Smith, Stitchingly Along. She has a Facebook group. I will try to link it underneath here. She had some good sales and I couldn't say no. I just have to say, I love how she packages everything too. She puts everything in a little organza bag or whatever and wraps it in tissue paper, and it's so nice to open. So thank you. Picked up this jack-o'-lantern one. So now I can switch them out seasonally. And an Easter egg that I failed to use for Easter. I wasn't paying attention or something. And this one I think is my favorite. It's not going to show up. It's a dragon. It's blues and purples. Come on, camera. Well, whatever. So, three new scissor fabs, and she had a really good sale. I think she still actually does have a really good sale / clearance going on. If you head over and check it out. She's on Etsy as well. Facebook, her group name is Stitchingly Along. I wonder if she changed that. I think I remember a notification popping up in my newsfeed. But that's Charisse Smith, and I'll try to find the link and put it down below. Last item also showed up today. Apparently a while back, I signed up for the Silver Needle. It's the shop in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I signed up for their friends. I don't know. I don't even remember what it's called. I was excited and clicking buttons or something. But I signed up for their, it's every other month, and you get, it is a limited edition type. You can only get it from them. Only get it if you're signed up for it. Today's came. It's the drawn thread. Threads that bind. I like the drawn thread. My first reaction was that I did not like this project, but as I'm looking at it, I am getting to like it a little bit more. She's stitching. How can you not like it? I don't know. I might change the colors. Changing the colors might help. Not sure that I'll make it into a sewing pocket. Because, like I said, I'm lazy. Look how long it took me to make my son's pillow ornament. But the pattern itself, I like it. And has the fabric threads. Cool. It also came with this little jar. I guess for orts. I don't know. Whatever. I'll use it. And it came with a needle nanny. Horrible glare. So sorry, guys. And it is that same stitcher from the pattern. That's pretty cool. I don't know. Whatever. I'll use it. So, that is all my goodies. That is all my finishes. That is all my whips. I kind of feel lost. Like, I don't know what project I'm going to work on now. Because I finished all these things. I don't have a pile on the edge of my counter anymore with half-finished projects. Well, obviously I have my pile of whips, but I don't have my finished stitches waiting to be made into pretties. Oh, the other thing I did this week, I used the best press that I purchased, and I ironed all of my pieces, and I put them in a storage bin underneath my bed for now until I can start getting stuff framed or whatever I'm going to do with it. Oh my god! Love the best press. So glad that I saw a thread on Stitch Mania about it. I just missed it very, very lightly. And I sprayed it on the backs of my pieces instead of the fronts. Ironed from the back. Everything came out so crisp. And I got the unscented, you know, the traditional, I don't know, regular scent, you know, no scent, no color that I can tell in the best press. I mean, I ironed this with it. Do you see a wrinkle? No. There are none. So I was excited about that. I also bought a small ironing board at Walmart. Strictly for ironing. My cross stitch. It was only $10 or something like that. But it's a little ironing board for putting on your counter. Because I'm not going to pull my big one out all the time. I don't have my quilting stuff out right now. The ironing board is folded up. It's an old ironing board, so it's bulky and heavy, and I don't like it anyway. This little one is perfect. I was able to use it. No problems on my kitchen counter. Fold the little legs back in and tuck it in my closet. So, it was worth it. I don't need anything bigger anyway. I don't iron my husband's clothes or anything like that. I don't buy clothes that I have to iron. That's dumb. Last thing that I have is actually questions. My husband works IT and hates Apple product. Only because he's IT. Anybody else out there knows IT, they probably understand it. I don't really, but whatever. We've never had iPhones. I have a Kindle, but I've never had an iPad, anything like that. But getting into more of the Flosstube PDF patterns, I'm really wondering if it's worth it to get an iPad. Only because I can get one for free right now. I used to sell Perfectly Posh. Still do, but one of the perks of being a distributor with Perfectly Posh was we accumulated these points, reward points, and you can use your reward points on all this stuff in this store. I can get an iPad with all of the points that I have because I've never turned them in. So, iPad. Easy to use. Good for making these videos, posting them, PDF patterns. I did pay for a version of, you know, some kind of PDF editor, or I don't remember what it was, for my Kindle. Haven't even used it. Don't even know where the Kindle is, to be honest. I don't know. Desperately needs to be charged, I'm sure. But I thought since I could get the iPad for free, be a nice reward for myself, and I could use it strictly for my stitching and start buying some of these patterns that are PDF instant downloads, cost less because they're PDFs. I've been buying the stitch along, the inspirational quotes stitch along from Stitcherovia on Etsy, and I haven't printed them out yet because they're in color. If I could use the PDF on an iPad or something and stitch just from that, I think that might be the route to go. So, I wouldn't be putting data on it, I don't think. I'd probably strictly just be using it at home. I'm guessing if you had a PDF, you wouldn't even have to be connected to Wi-Fi or anything to work on that. It's probably just saved to the device. So I'm thinking that I'd be good with just tapping into Wi-Fi at home. But let me know your thoughts. Let me know what you use. I think that I've seen people mention editing Flosstube videos with an app through Apple. I don't know. I don't know anything. So, but that's it. That's everything I got for you today. I'm gonna go try to find something to stitch tonight because my gym class got canceled. Or maybe I'll move some flowers. I've got some flowers in the backyard, and we're gonna demolish the backyard and plant grass. Maybe I'll move some of those flowers to the front yard. I'm gonna plant some of the daffodils and tulips around our mailbox and tree. It's pretty nice out. I should probably do that. We'll see. If I do, maybe I'll show you a picture later. Have a good week. Hope everybody has some successful stitching. Get some finishes done, just like I did. But yeah, let me know what you think about the iPad and oh, the mat board, the whatever you guys do. Curious. And I'll see you guys next week.